It's been hailed as a vision of the future.
The West Kowloon Station is a gigantic $10 billion glass and concrete structure that houses a high-speed rail link between Hong Kong and mainland China.
The Hong Kong government considers this an economic game changer. It helps the city's economy by bringing in more visitors while linking Hong Kong to Macau and cities across southern China. But this glittering development is deeply controversial. That's because the station has an area where all passengers going to the mainland are pre-screened by Chinese immigration.
Yes, it's a setup similar to those seen in the UK and Canada, where officials from France and the United States pre-screen passengers for the sake of efficiency. But those officials only have the power to approve or deny entry.
Departing passengers will need to comply with mainland laws.
It's more complicated here. In part of the West Kowloon Station, mainland Chinese laws apply. That means Chinese authorities can make arrests inside the terminal or even transfer people to the mainland. Critics fear this foothold could allow Chinese police to go after government critics in the city.
It will erode the highly autonomy of Hong Kong and against the one country, two system principle.
Defenders say the joint checkpoint makes for a smoother immigration process to facilitate the journey from Hong Kong to over 40 destinations in China.
And that's why mainland Chinese police are stationed here in the commercial heart of Hong Kong. Christy Lu Stout, CNN, Hong Kong.
As President Donald Trump prepares to depart for the G7 in France, sources say he's questioning why he should attend a conference he sees as unproductive. The last two gatherings of the world's top leaders ended acrimoniously, with Trump feeling like he isn't given enough time to tout his achievements, like the economy, according to sources.
The economy has been really fantastic.
Trump also triggered today by new Chinese tariffs, huddling with his economic advisors in the White House, attempting to unveil immediate retaliation and firing off a string of tweets writing, quote, "Our country has lost, stupidly, trillions of dollars with China over many years. I won't let that happen. We don't need China and, frankly, would be far better off without them." Trump also adding a demand he doesn't have the power to enforce, tweeting, "Our great American companies are hereby ordered to immediately start looking for an alternative to China, including bringing your companies home and making your products in the USA." Trump advisor Peter Navarro telling CNN the tariffs are emboldening Trump.
When China reacts like this, what they simply do is strengthen the resolve of this president, and they signal once again to the American public that China wants to buckle our knees so that they can keep having their way with us.
Trump also assailing Jerome Powell after the Fed chairman acknowledged troubling signs in the economy, but gave no signal the Fed would follow Trump's call to cut interest rates next month. Speaking at an economic symposium, Powell saying, quote, "We're carefully watching developments as we assess their implications for the U.S. outlook and the path of monetary policy." In response, the president tweeting in part, "As usual, the Fed did nothing. We have a very strong dollar and a very weak Fed. My only question is, who is our bigger enemy, Jay Powell or Chairman Xi?"
Janie Fuller Phelps is running a new kind of daycare here in Huntington, West Virginia.
This is the first program of its kind anywhere in the United States.
It's just for babies like Huck, who were born exposed to drugs.
They experience twitching, some experience tremors.
It's seven-week-old Olivia's first day. Her teacher, Catherine Jones, tries to soothe her.
It's exceptionally difficult to hear him cry sometimes. And there are times you just feel helpless, hopeless. It is disheartening that it has come to this. It has become a crisis.
West Virginia has the highest drug overdose death rate in the nation. In the past 10 years, the number of people in this state who fatally overdosed on drugs more than doubled. In recent years, at this hospital in Huntington, one out of five babies was born exposed to opioids in the womb. It started because the cities and towns in this Appalachian Mountain state were flooded with prescription opioids. Enough to give 66 pills a year to every man, woman, and child in West Virginia from 2006 to 2012, according to a recent investigation by the Washington Post. The state cracked down on the pills, so now heroin has flourished, and so has fentanyl. And that leaves Beverly and Andrew Reiling raising their grandchildren Andriana, Jacob, and Gabriel. The children's mother, addicted. Their father, dead because of opioids.
My oldest son, the father of these three children, died in an automobile accident with another young man who was also involved in drugs. Their birth mom had been involved in drugs.
So you and your husband are 70 years old, and you're raising three children?
Yes.
Are you the only grandparents raising grandchildren?
Hundreds, thousands.
Because of drugs?
Because of drugs, absolutely, absolutely.
The first months of Andriana's life were spent in excruciating pain as doctors weaned her off oxycodone. In October, her grandparents filed a lawsuit on her behalf against several opioid manufacturers. Her lawyer, Booth Goodwin, is screening about 200 more children for similar lawsuits. As a U.S. attorney under President Obama, Goodwin helped lead a fight to shut down pill mills in West Virginia.
Why has the drug problem hit so badly here?
It's not just one thing that's led to this crisis. We're a region with backbreaking industry that leads to injury, that leads to drugs being prescribed.
There's a relatively high joblessness rate here.
The economic issues that we face here in Appalachia, that's left a lot of people out of work. It leads to frustration.
This state has seen challenges with rural health care.
It's difficult to get good quality health care to all the nooks and crannies of our rural state.
There are some signs that the situation in West Virginia is improving, if even slightly. In Cabell County, where Huntington is located, the number of calls to 911 for suspected overdoses so far in 2019, it's less than half what it was for the same time period 2 years ago. And more people who've overdosed are getting treatment, thanks to the work of this new intervention team, a paramedic, a police officer, an addiction counselor, and a pastor. In June, the National Institutes of Health announced a $5.8 million grant to expand research into opioid addiction in Appalachia. Back at the child care center, Olivia is feeling better, thanks to the teacher's tender, loving care. But despite the progress against drug addiction,
the demand continues.
Yes, I have active referrals sitting on my desk right now and a waiting list.
A waiting list for care for the tiniest victims of opioids in West Virginia.